Welcome back. The big important day has arrived. I have successfully tested the tube power section. Quite happy about the outcome. It works really well. But before looking at that, just a quick recap of the last videos, of the last steps. As you know, I'm currently designing and working on a tube stereo receiver. As the name suggests, this equipment will include the FM tuner, and will include the Bluetooth receiver as well, and the digital to analog converter module as well. So now in this video you will see the tests which I've been doing on the power supply section feeding the tube, and then finally you will see the successful tests on the power tube section. Thank you very much. Let's give a look at that. As one of the first important tests to do on the amplifier, it's very important to test, to check the power supply unit. Some section of that were tested already, as you might remember, but now the power supply unit is fully completed and also fully installed in the final position. So it's very important to check each and every voltage coming out from the power supply unit. I did that and successfully, so I'm quite happy about that. So as a first step, I checked again the 5 volt coming out from the standby section of the power supply. As you remember, within the power supply unit there is a transformer. You will remember this red transformer. This is part of the standby section which keeps Arduino microcontroller always powered on. So the 5 volts are there correctly, so that's fine. Also, I tested the correct functionality of this relay. This is the standby relay. This is driven by Arduino. The user can move, can switch from standby situation to operation situation through a switch or through the remote controller. In this way, Arduino sends a 5 volt voltage to the relevant pin within this section, and then the relay engages and puts the main power transformer, which is this one, in direct communication with the 230 volts coming from the power network. So this is working, this is working correctly. For the moment I'm just using a 5 volt, not coming from Arduino, but this is correctly engaging. So when engaged, I can see all the needed voltages at the output of my power supply unit. So I then measured all the voltages. All are working fine. So starting from the tube's polarization, the tube's bias, here, as you remember, I have 4 different outputs here, one for each power tube. Here I have from minus 15 to minus 50 volts adjustable on a tube by tube basis, and this is fine. Then here I have the high voltage for the tubes. This is for all the tubes in a cascaded fashion, starting from the power tubes. Here I have a slightly higher voltage than expected, but this is normal because when I did the test I did not have the load connected, so I didn't have the tubes connected. I read about 550 volt, which again is 100 volt higher than more or less 100 volt higher than what I calculated, but again this is normal. I expect when I will connect the tubes and all the section, when I connect the load basically, I expect the power, the high voltage will settle 560, 570 volt, more or less, which is what I expect. The voltage rating of the supply capacitors is 600 volt, so it's not a problem. I mean, even if I temporarily provided them 550 volt, this is still within the limits of the supply capacitors. So this is fine. Then I have the stabilized DC 12.6 volt for the heater, for the phase splitter and the preamplifier tubes. This is working. Then I have the 6.3 volt stabilized DC voltage for the other tubes, the EF86 heater, and this is working again. Then I have the alternate current 6.3 volt for the power tubes. Heaters. Power tubes are the only tubes which are heated by alternate current, which is not a problem for sake of noise, for two reasons. So the first is that the tubes, the power tubes are configured in push-pull configuration, thus canceling the noise somewhat. And second reason is that the level of the signal handled by the power tubes is far higher than any possible noise coming from the AC voltage for the heater. And then I have all the DC voltage, stabilized DC voltage, for the remaining sections of the tube receiver. For example, I have here 12 volt for the input selection unit, I have 8 volt for the digital to analog converter, 5 volt for the receiver, digital receiver within the digital to analog converter, 12 volt for the Bluetooth receiver and 12 volt for the FM tuner. And everything is working as it should. So, time for the first important test has come. In this moment you might see the amplifier is powered on. You might see from the heaters which are lit in this moment. Of course the amplifier is not playing any music, but as you might hear, there is absolutely no noise nor hum coming out from the speakers. The amplifier is really dead quiet when not playing music, and I think this is a very good first achievement. Let's just play some test music. In this moment I have connected an external Bluetooth receiver. I mean, it's not the one which will be integrated into the chassis. And again, let's play some music through the mobile phone. So, as you might appreciate, the amplifier is working really, really well. Of course, much work still ahead of me. Just one note, in this moment the amplifier is open loop, so no feedback implemented at this stage. But the fact that there is no noise, the amplifier is really dead quiet, even in open loop layout configuration, is really very, very promising. I will decide later if implement some little bit of feedback, essentially based on the measurements I will take on the amplifier, and I would say first of all based on my ears, based on listening sessions. After the first quick listening test, let's give a look at the inside of the amplifier. As you can see, this is not the final layout, I would say. I plan to make it more neat, let's say. But I think it can give a good idea of how the amplifier is arranged. From top to bottom, you can see in the top part of the screen, this is the power supply module we have commented already. Just one quick note about that. You might notice these four wires, each one has a different color. These four wires carry the polarization voltage feeding the grids of the power tubes. So the polarization voltage is negative, of course, it's in the neighborhood of minus 45, minus 50 volt. And again, each one is adjustable, so I have the possibility to adjust each and every power tube polarization in order, of course, to match the particular specification of each and every power tube. Another comment about this part here, we commented already, the amplifier will have a standby mode. So as soon as it will be powered up through a switch on the back, the amplifier will only Arduino will be powered on. So this will be the standby mode. Arduino only will be powered on. But as soon as the user will act on a switch, I will include in the front panel, or a button on the remote control, Arduino will send a positive 5 volt here, and this will engage a relay you might see here, and this relay will put the 230 volt coming from the power network in direct communication with the primary coil of the main power transformer. It's in the bottom. So in this way, by acting on a switch on the front panel or a button on the remote control, this relay will power on all the sections of the amplifier. In this moment, as Arduino is not here for the moment, temporarily, I have just temporarily connected this red wire, which is feeding 5 volt coming from the stabilizer here. The stabilized power supply here, I have connected it to this pin. This is just temporarily. Again, in the future, this will be driven by Arduino. Also, the power supply section provides all the stabilized voltages. You can see these colored wires here and also this yellow wire here. Provides all the voltages which will be needed for all the amplifier section. For example, in this this yellow wire carries the stabilized 12 volts, which will be used by the FM tuner. This purple wire carries already 8 volts, which will be used by the digital to analog converter, and so on. So, of course, these are not currently used for the moment, but they will in the future as soon as the build will progress. You might see also some shielded wires coming from the front panel. These are the left and right channel auxiliary input, and they will be used as soon as I will complete the preamplifier and the input selection unit. This is the smoothing coil. Is very big, it might be a little bit overkill. This smoothing coil can handle 400 milliamps, which again is a little bit overkill, but I think it's responsible, has a part of role in the very good performance of the amplifier with regards to the signal to noise ratio. As we have seen, the amplifier is dead quiet, and I think a good part of that comes from the smoothing coil. Also, you can see here, I promise it will be more neat in the future, but this is the central grounding point. As I mentioned in the last video, I have implemented a very strict, very rigid star ground scheme. As you can see, really each and every ground wire coming from all over the circuits are connected in the same point. And again, I think this is the second driver which makes the amplifier really dead quiet when no music is playing. So the signal to noise performance of the amplifier is really very good, and again part of the reason is this star grounding point, star grounding architecture. Coming to the description of the power amplifier, you can see the two channels here. So this is the left channel or right channel, because the amplifier is upside down. Right channel power amplifier, and this is the left channel power amplifier. The preamplifier is still not completed. These are the two preamplifier sockets, which again is not completed. So coming to the power amplifier, here we can see the first gain stage. This is the EF86 first gain stage. Then we have the phase splitter, the inverter, based on the ECC81 tube, and these are the four power tubes. As you can see here, we have at the output of the of each phase splitter, at the output of these two yellow capacitors, I have the two legs of the phase splitter. So here I have two signals. One is the inverted version of the other one, which will be combined by the two power tubes, because as you remember, the power tubes are configured in push-pull layout. A final comment, as you remember, I didn't implement any feedback loop, and in fact you might see there is no wire coming from going from the output, the speaker's output here, to any part of the power amplifier, and because again I see that the performance of the amplifier are really very good even without feedback. I will decide later if implement some little bit of feedback based on the measurement I will still need to take on the amplifier, and also on the based on listening further listening tests. So, pretty nice, I believe, quite a good progress, I think. Thank you very much for your attention, and see you in the next video. Thank you, bye.